Hey, Jen, what are you doing here?
Hey, you know, I'm just out here test driving the new Girls on the Run 5K pace car.
Oh, the new pace car from Bert Watson. That's awesome. What a cool idea.
Pretty much the coolest pace car we've ever had.
I can imagine. This is a pretty cool pace car. Hopefully it'll keep up with your girls. They're pretty fast, I bet.
I don't know. We're going to have to see. I'm not sure about that.
So when is this 5K?
The 5K is November 23rd, so coming up here in just a couple months.
Okay. And so what do you guys do there? It's obviously you run.
Sure. Well, we run, we walk, we just have a big celebration.
Okay.
It is the culminating event for the Girls on the Run Saginaw Bay program in our region. So we will be out there in downtown Saginaw with 300 girls, over 100 coaches, and a whole bunch of community members just celebrating the end of the season.
Okay, cool. Now we're going to get back to the Girls on the Run, but one thing I want to talk about real quick is, first of all, welcome to episode 50 of Watson Wednesday. So come around here to the back so we can take a look at the truck. We're going to do a quick breeze over and then we'll do a quick interview with Jen, okay? So we talked about this truck a little bit briefly, but remember it's got that dual exhaust, so you can hear that rumbling right now. You can see the embossed Chevrolet bow tie emblems. All the tie down stakes. It's got lighted cargo box. Obviously this is a little bit bigger truck. We could probably put several of those girls in here for the Girls on the Run if they want to do a parade or something fun. So the Chevrolet tailgate, Silverado RST, and it's the RMT edition. So it's the Rocky Mountain Truck Works edition, RMT Diamond edition. So I don't know if today is dark enough or not to see, but when we open up these doors, no, it's not quite dark enough still. One of these videos, I'm going to show you these doors, but when you open up the door, there's a really cool diamond emblem that displays on the ground here. It's a really neat little thing here. And like I said, the RMT edition, diamond edition, it's got the steps. Obviously, it's got a lift kit, as you can see. Big wheel flares. So this is our official Girls on the Run pace car. And we're here with Jen Naegele again. So Jen's here. And so for those who don't know, Jen Naegele is Girls on the Run. What's your title?
I'm the council director.
Council director
in our area, yes.
And so I don't know a ton about Girls on the Run, so we're going to talk about Girls on the Run today. Bert Watson has been a sponsor of Girls on the Run for how many years?
Since 2012.
2012.
So that is an amazing 7 years that Bert Watson has been supporting the girls through our program. It's incredible.
So Girls on the Run does what?
So we inspire girls in 3rd through 8th grade to be more joyful and healthy and confident. And we do this with a 10-week after-school program that sort of creatively weaves in running, walking, and movement, and just a lot of fun activities.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And obviously with that, with healthy environments and positive eating and everything, mm-hmm. comes happier, more confident girls.
Sure. So we're inspiring girls with really amazing life skills. So they are learning empathy and compassion, character. They're learning how to stand up for each other, how to stand up for themselves, embrace our uniqueness, our differences. And all through the program, they are training to run or walk in a 5K celebration event that we'll be doing here with Bert Watson in a couple months.
Okay, so obviously Bert Watson's a big sponsor of that. We appreciate you guys, and obviously our community is big for us. Everybody here at Bert Watson realizes that we sponsor and support a lot of different UAWs, and we do the Shiawassee Flats, and we do obviously Girls on the Run. We do the Freeland High School and Middle School, and we do a lot of sponsors and donations and try to be involved in our community. This is just one really cool facet of what we do. And so the Girls on the Run 5K is November the 23rd.
November 23rd, yes.
Okay, and you'll have, this is a Michigan thing, right?
It's a Michigan thing for us. We serve girls in Saginaw Bay, Aranac, Tuscola, and Huron counties. Although we're part of a really awesome movement nationwide. There's Girls on the Run programs all over. But right here, we are serving girls right here in our local community every year.
Okay, so this doesn't just reach the end of Michigan borders. This is bigger than Michigan.
It's bigger. It's nationwide.
Wow, really?
Amazing. We're part of something really big, and it's such a positive, impactful program. And it's because of sponsors like Bert Watson that we can do what we can do.
Okay.
And, you know, it's an inclusive program. No girls are ever turned away for inability to pay the registration fee. So donations from Bert Watson, since the beginning, have helped us serve over 2,500 girls.
Wow, that's a huge number. Say that again,
2,500
girls that Bert Watson has in some way helped,
yes,
to bring up confidence and healthy living. And yeah, wow, that's really awesome, 2,500, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's amazing. So it's wonderful, and we're so excited to celebrate with you then at the 5K on November 23rd, which I have to say is open to the community. So sometimes people hear Girls on the Run, they think, what is this all about? It's a celebration for the girls. It's basically a framework for setting and achieving life goals that's happening at this 5K. However, it's open to men, women, kids of all ages. So people will come out and they get a pair of foam reindeer antlers. So it's a big herd of people running through. It's our reindeer run.
A big herd.
It's a big celebration running through downtown Saginaw, starting at the Castle Museum. It goes down Washington through the city and ends at the Anderson and Richmond Center. We are followed by, we headed up by this amazing pace car, and then we're followed by the downtown Saginaw holiday parade, too. So it's just a celebration in the city.
The whole city will be celebrating.
And if you register for this run, not only will you have a blast and get your antlers, you will receive a hand-painted finisher's medallion made right by our girls, and your registration fee will support the program, which allows more girls to go
through
the program.
So this is actually another fundraiser to help with Girls on the Run.
It is.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yes.
Okay, so it's not just for fun, so you can run around and be crazy and wear antlers. You're actually making money for...
It puts the fun in fundraiser, right?
That's cute.
We're just going to say that.
Okay, all right. So I'm obviously not going to run in the 5K, but maybe I'll drive the pace car. I don't know.
What?
I don't know.
I mean, it's a pretty sweet ride, I'm saying.
You're probably driving that one. Maybe I'll follow you guys up with like a Corvette or something. I don't know.
Fun. Oh, you just race the bar.
Well, that's what we do here at Burt Watson.
That's right, you do.
Yeah, so this is cool. So this is our official pace car of the Girls on the Run. And so again, Jen Naegele, and hopefully you guys will see her out November the 23rd. Registration costs what?
The registration right now is open for $25 a person. If you register a family of four or more, you do receive a $5 discount.
Okay.
And then as of October 1, it's $30 a person, but the same group discount rate applies. You can go right to GOTRSaginawBay.org to register for that 5K.
Say that again, G-O-T-R.
Yeah, GOTRSaginawBay.org.
.org, okay. Yes. And we'll put that in our comment section there so you can get registered. Obviously, we all here at Burt Watson support the idea. We'd love for our customers and clients and our vendors to all support the idea. So Girls on the Run is a really big deal. This is how many years?
It's been since 2010. We've been serving girls in our area.
And how many years is this 5K been going?
Same thing, 2010.
Wow, so it's the original. Okay.
Yeah, we're approaching our 10-year anniversary.
This is the ninth anniversary then, right? The ninth annual event at the... What is the location in Saginaw again?
The Castle Museum is where the festivities start. And
$25 registration.
$25 registration.
And come out and see the pace car and Jen Naegele.
That's right.
Again, thanks guys. Have a great day.
Thank you.